12,431, 12,432, 12,433, 12,434, 12,435.
Pardon me. Can you tell me where 123 East 73rd Street is?
Yes, it's two blocks over and one block down. 12,448.
Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. It isn't 123 East 73rd Street. It's 173 East 23rd Street.
12,450. Then I suggest you take the 12,451. 814 bus. 12,452. This will take you right down to 42nd, 12,453. 42nd Street, where you take the cross down, 12,444. And the cross down will take you over to the east side, 12,449.
Oh, I am sorry. It isn't East 23rd Street, it's West 23rd Street.
Well, in that case, you don't 12,556. You don't take the 12,556. You don't take the cross town. You just take the A14 right down 12,557, right down to 23rd Street and get to the 700 block and you'll find 12,551. You'll find it there.
Oh, thank you. Do you have the time?
Yes, it's about 3 minutes past 8.
8:03?
Yes, 8:03.
Thank you very much.
Not at all.
Roger Williams, with the Bob Hamilton Dancers, Henry Lasco, Al Kelly, with Peter Hanley, Bill Wendell, Barbara. And now here's the star of our show, Ernie Kovacs.
Thank you. I'm just telling the audience, I just got here. Every night at 7 o'clock, we have a thing where I disappear. And right across the street, there's a club that lets me in. And I go over there and sneak in and go swimming. And they had a polo, this is the truth, they had a water polo game going on tonight. And I got in the steam room, which is 140 degrees, and you get very hot. And there's a big vein that comes out in my head. And if I don't get in the pool before I come back, I perspire. Oh, svad, yes, svad, all through the show, svad. So I wanted to get in the pool to cool off, and there was a water polo game going on. And the only thing I could do was to slip in on one end, slide down and go down to the bottom, and swim all the way across with the tile, scraping your stomach, all the way through the other end. And when I got up, my ears have been stopped up. I can't hear a thing. So, laugh loud if you laugh. It goes, real thing. Awfully concerned tonight about the weather here in New York. Has been pouring. It's just on Madison Avenue, it's been raining pedigreed animals. It's been a terrible thing. We've had all of this water coming down, pouring, and you come out here and hold the beer. I'll go back there. Rascal, he's younger than we are. And it's been raining so hard, we were so surprised to see everybody come up, and we thank you so much, really, truly. You have no idea. Well, of course, you killed our alibi. I was going to tell the boss that it was raining, you know, there's no people up there. So, if you don't laugh now, we're sunk. We're really sunk, because they know you're up there. I've spilled the beans. One thing happened last week. At the end of the show, we had the White Rock girl fall off the rock and in the water. And the White Rock people were awfully nice about it, but they did feel that it was a bit not too dignified and everything. So we thought that we would sort of set things right by the White Rock people after knocking the girl in the water. Would you fix them up a little bit, please? We're always kidding vice presidents. I guess it's kind of a thing to do. But every now and then they sort of get even with us. And one of them
asked us if we would be so kind as to put his nephew on television. Well, you don't want to say no to, you know, a big deal and everything like that. So we got the kid up to audition, and we asked him what he does. He doesn't do anything, and then when we looked at him, we kind of felt that he wasn't just right for television. Bring Yancey out, will you? Yancey? This is Yancey. Now, here's what I mean. You see back here? He can read newspapers through his head and all that. And this is a... Thanks, Yancey. This is why we didn't want to use him. But you know how they are. They're funny people. We've had a lot of fun. I have used up 2 tons of paper each week sketching out little things for dances, and Bob Hamilton has been there and chirping with this and that, and we've had an awful lot of fun setting up dances. Then we began wondering just how you people look at dances and how the average audience just looks at a dance. So we decided to set our cameras up on a cross-section of a typical audience here in this country that watches television. Now, here is a typical cross-section of the audience. For instance, there's a little boy who's a shoeshine boy. He shines shoes for a living. And next to him is a gentleman who is a tonsorial expert, obviously a barber. And right beside him is another gentleman who is obviously what he looks like to be. Thank you, a gentleman who might be called a bon vivant, one who gets around to the better places where there are girls and things like that. So we thought we would like you to see Bob Hamilton, his trio and dancers, dance as seen by the eyes of these three people individually. Thank you.
out there, boys and girls. Time again for one of your favorite programs. Let's take a visit with Uncle Buddy and his two little friends, Mary, Margaret, and Ricky. Well, I'll just bet that all you boys and girls can hardly wait to find out where Uncle Buddy and his two little friends are going to visit today. So let's join them, shall we?
Boys and girls, it's your Uncle Buddy again, back again to visit with you. We know from your letters that you've learned a lot from our little visits and your questions in the mail, such as, Uncle Buddy, why don't you take a trip to the moon? And like that. Boys and girls, you'll never guess where we're visiting today. Oh, and here are my little friends, Ricky and Mary Margaret. Ricky, would you tell the boys and girls where we're visiting today? Did you tell the boys and girls we're visiting today? That's right, Mary Margaret and Ricky. Good boy. We're taking a ferry ride.
I read a story once about a little girl who took a ferry ride.
I'm sure she enjoyed it just as much as we're going to enjoy our trip today.
She was drinking soda, and when the boat started, she spilled it, the soda on her.
That's nice. Now, our boat is leaving New York, and we're on the Staten Island Ferry. Do you know where it's going to take us? Do you know where it's going to take us?
I'm Staten Island!
Staten Island. And do you know something else about this drive?
Staten Island! We're both going to Staten Island!
No, the something else is that it's the longest nickel ferry ride in the world.
Does this boat go to England, too?
What?
England.
Not England.
This girl who spilled it at the soda, she was an orphan.
An orphan? An orphan, this girl who spilled it at... What girl?
The girl I read in the book about.
Hello, boys and girls. This is your Uncle Buddy. And my little friend, Ricky, Mary, Margaret, we're visiting Staten Island today. We're on the Staten Island Ferry. And the Staten Island Ferry goes to Staten Island.
Is there a ferry to bring you back to New York?
This ferry brings you back to New York.
I learned lots on this program. I love to take a visit. I love going on ferry trips. I love the visit to the farm. I love being on this program. I love learning things. I love...
And what do you children think you're going to see on this ferry trip over the water?
The Statue of Liberty.
The Statue of Liberty.
I love the Statue of Liberty. I love water.
That's right, Mary Margaret. We should love everything.
I love everything.
I know. Well, sir, soon we're going to see that grand old lady, the Statue of Liberty.
I love the Statue of Liberty.
And another thing about her is this. The people of France gave the Statue of Liberty to the people of the United States. And the people of the United States accepted the statue with a kind of cementing of the relationship. And the people of France thought that perhaps... What are you doing, Ricky?
Just going back and forth.
What for?
Well, it's an experiment. I just want to see if it works. One of the kids told me that if you sway back and forth when you're on a boat, the people watching you get seasick.
I love seasick people. When I grow up, I'm going to... I love seasick people. When I grow up, I'm going to be a nurse. I'd love to visit a hospital.
You may. Ricky, come here. Come over to the rail. I want to show you something.
Can we see England now?
No, little friend. We're here to learn things. Just stand next to me here at the rail.
Well, sometimes you get mad at me and scare me.
Oh, no, I don't. Now, come here. There's nothing to be angry with you. Why should I be angry? You come here and say to your old Uncle Buddy.
I don't think so. I think you are angry at me.
I'm not angry with you.
Well, I'm going to walk on the rail.
You're not going to walk on the rail. Now, Mary Margaret, did I tell you about the people of France who gave the people of the United States the Statue of Liberty?
No, Uncle Buddy. You didn't tell me about the people of France who gave the people of the United States the Statue of Liberty. Who gave the people of the United States the Statue of Liberty?
That's a very good question, Mary Margaret. The people of France gave the people of the United States the Statue of Liberty.
I love the people of France. I love the Mau Maus, too.
Do you know what drives this ferry boat?
The captain?
Yes, sir, it's steam. Good old steam drives this ferry boat.
You know where steam comes from?
I love where it comes from. Some steam is very warm.
So many facts for such a little head. And someone in the boiler room shovels coal on the fire to make steam.
He's called the stoker.
He's called the stoker.
And he takes orders from the engineer.
And he takes orders from the engineer. Third mate! You know what I used to do when I was a little boy? I always walked on the rails. I used to hop and skip. You know what else I used to do? Nobody in the whole world could do this. You couldn't do it in a million years. I used to walk backwards. Well, I see by the hands on the old clock, boys and girls, we've reached the end of our little visit for today. And be back next week when we're going to visit some more strange and wonderful places.
I love visiting strange and wonderful places.
Oh, boy. Ricky, bend down. I want to show you something. Here's something else that Uncle Buddy used to do. Now, this is a blindfold, just like Uncle Buddy used to wear. And you just tie it around here and knot it very tightly. Now, so long, boys and girls. Now, I turn you around three times, Buddy. Uncle Buddy will do that. All right. There are all forms of art which each one of us individually likes. Some of us like the modern, some like the ancient, some of us like the present-day cartoon form. I've always had a little thing that I do on my desk that I just do with eyes. I call them orbicatures, and they have nothing but eyes and just conversation. I thought maybe if you'd like to look at these, the art department took some of my drawings and enlarged them, and they are called orbicatures, and I'd like to show you a few. Just eyes and some captions.
He looks just like his daddy.
Well, I know, Mrs. Creel. Henry wasn't with me last night.
She's disgraceful. Why, that bathing suit hardly comes... Albert?
I told good old Joe you'd love to have him for dinner tonight.
Why, you clumsy! Hey, these cards are marked on the back.
No, the collar is still way too small.
Along the lines of our growing up, we look back into a very pleasant era of our lives when we opened doors into little rooms where toys were spread in profusion. And we picked up little teddy bears, and somehow you've never forgotten the touch of a teddy bear or this bright paint on a wooden soldier. You've never forgotten the little cars you used to push. And I think one of the most beautiful songs, strangely, I think it's for adults rather than for children. Edie Adams sings it, Toyland.
Within it, you are tax 12. The fun's begun. The dolls are in their best array. There's going to be a wonderful parade. Hark to the drum. Oh, here they come, cries everyone. Hear them all cheering. Now they are nearing. There's the captain, stiff and starch. Bayonets flashing. Music is crashing as the wooden soldiers march. Sabers are clinking. Soldiers are winking at each pretty little maid. Here they come. Here they come. For it's the holiday. Today is the wedding of the painted doll. It's a jolly day. The news is spreading all around the hall.
With your Hollywood reporter, here he is, Scott Nasilski.
This is Scott Nasilski with news, views, and interviews out from and about Hollywood, U.S. of A. I open my broadcast on a shocking note. Nude photos of Trigger, the Wonder Horse, are being sold under the counter in Hollywood, much to the dismay of Trigger's friend, Bullet, the Wonder Dog. It is rumored that Trigger posed for these nude pictures many years ago when he was down on his luck and working as an extra in Tom Mix pictures. Some of the horses at Hialeah, who are doing most of the snickering, have no room to talk. With those tiny English saddles, they might as well be wearing nothing at all. A happy marital note enters Scott Nasilski's broadcast tonight. Now that he has made $3 million as a leading man in pictures, Rob Fluma says he will begin spending more time with his wife, Verna Baker, who is now married to Jerome Kennedy. And now a word about Cicerine Costello, the fiery star from sunny Italy. You may remember her in the Italian picture, The Bicycle Thief. She played one of the sprockets. Miss Costello's measurements have caused quite a stir in Hollywood. 56, 58, 164, and 71. Frankly, Miss Costello makes Gina Lola Brigida look like John Foster Dulles. Monistone Studios must be congratulated on their novel attempt to cash in on the success of horror films and pictures about big business. They are combining the best features of both in their new release, The Creature in the New Flannel Suit. And now, for a peek at family life in Hollywood. Harold LaRock, recently married to Fred O'Hara, hopes their expected child will be a girl. They have four other children and plan to adopt a little girl if the next child is not a girl. For as Harold says, we want to have our family while we're still young. Harold is 14 and Frida is 6. And now here is Scott Nasilski's movie boner of the week. It's from the Septic Studios' new release, Moby Dick Meets Abbott Costello. In the scene in which the boner occurs, we see Kirk Douglas dressed for the evening, wearing a tuxedo with white tie, opera cape, a diving long, and swim fins on his feet. He goes to the hospital to meet June Allison, who is playing the head nurse. Miss Allison, of course, is crying. She is dressed in conventional nurse's costume, a starched white smock, Japanese sumari sword, orange galoshes, and a gray Homburg. As Kirk enters the hospital, Miss Allison is about to inject a patient with penicillin, with her vision constantly being blurred by tears. She jams the hypodermic into a hairdryer by mistake. The hairdryer is played by George Liberace. At that moment, the elderly resident surgeon, Lou Costello, comes hurrying down the corridor to the operating room and sees Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, played by Jimmy and Tommy Dorsey, performing an emergency operation on Benny Goodman and Steve Allen. As one of them has just swallowed a clarinet. In the excitement, the Hungarian janitor, excellently portrayed by Anita Ekberg, comes in to find out how she can get the egg off the end of a plastic Band-Aid. When she slips on a cake of medicated soap and slides into young Dr. Kildare, played by Howdy Doody. Just then, Lassie, who has been shaving in the ladies' room, leaps out, bites Benny Goodman on the ankle, and dashes off to the lab to invent a cure for rabies. Now, here is where the boner occurs. And it is one of great incongruity. As Sabu rides by on a guinea pig, which is being examined for German measles, we see a close-up of the alarm clock on Dr. Costello's wrist. The hands show the time to be 12 o'clock noon. If it is 12 o'clock noon, how come nobody is eating lunch? Just what time is it, Hollywood? Now, this is Scotty Sutsky, your motion picture reporter, saying goodbye with his news, views, and interviews from Hollywood, U.S. of A.
Africa, land of mystery and eerie ways, of lions, elephants, hyenas, lizards, of mystic voodoo rites, and home to Lena, queen of the jungle.
There were just the three of us. I, Grace Murphy, daughter of a wealthy Philadelphia family, my fiancé, Paul Feldman, and our trustworthy guide, Judson Humis. We were looking for my brother, Eugene Murphy, deep in the swamps of Africa.
Yes, there was just the three of us.
Were.
There were just the three of us. Our safari carried Grace's personal things and Flint.
And this is Judson Humis, guide and translator, wise in the ways of the jungle, and it is rumored, friend to Lena, queen of the jungle. As we begin our story, we find Lena at her jungle bath.
Tonight. You can put the love seat right there, Irving. Oh, no, on second thought, I think I'd like it back up there. Oh, let's see now. Oh, that plank. Would you remove it, please? It doesn't look just right. You may go, Irving. Oh, I'm frightened, Paul. Look, Judson. A lion is charging one of our gun bearers.
He's charging one of our best natives, Mambo Gassi!
Oh, not Mambo Gassi. He's carrying my nylon. Oh, I'm so glad you're with us, Judson. You are so wise in the ways of the jungle.
Oh, by the way, Here comes an African rhinoceros, a dangerous beast.
Well, no one save us. Look, look, Judson, Paul, up there, on that vine directly above us.
It's Sheena, Lena, the beautiful goddess of the jungle, Lena.
She is beautiful.
Man do bad things when man shoot Lena and jungle friend. Not good do bad thing, is good do good thing.
Then the legend of Lena, the white goddess of the jungle, is true. I'm frightened, Paul.
Yes. Lena, friend of all beasts of jungle. Lena talked to many jungle beasts. Lena got many bites in arms and legs. Here come Albert, chimpanzee friend of Lena.
Oh, he has a note. What does it say?
NBC vice president come to put Lena on television. Where he be, Albert? Excuse Lena. She go welcome NBC vice president. I won't need this.
Murphy, your brother is someplace in Africa, and we'll find him.
I'm frightened, Paul. Oh, Lena. Lena, you can talk to animals. Perhaps you can go to them and get some information from them.
Lena, go talk to Hisso, the snake.
Oh.
Hello, Hisso. What is new? She did with medicine, man? Oh, lovely. What'd her mother say?
I'm frightened, Paul.
Oh. Well, that not good. That not bad, but that not good. Leave it there, Chief Hisso.
Oh, I'm discouraged, Paul. We'll never find Brother Eugene.
Wait. Lena, just remember something. Lena see big white bird.
Paul, she seen an aeroplane.
If Lena see airplane, she say airplane. Lena see big white bird. Oh.
What's that?
That drums of Wicked Chief Kabuna.
I'm frightened.
Lena, go find Kabuna.
This part jungle taboo.
Taboo? I love the stuff.
This my medicine man. He say you go. Say you go.
You go!
You speak Kabuna's tongue, Judson. Would you tell him that we're looking for my brother, Eugene?
Pandale yat no vintla het for stay. I'm a matus parawat a say to tibi, brother Eugene.
What did he say?
I'm frightened, Paul.
He's frightened, Paul.
Abuna like Grace Murphy.
A lot of trouble with that. Kabuna, not touch Philadelphia debutante. Not bad. Not bad to do that. Not good. Not good to do what bad. Not good to touch Philadelphia debutante.
Lena, please, Kabuna have splitting headache. How do we know Grace Murphy, brother, in this part of Africa?
Well, Eugene has been missing for the past 9 years. I'm frightened, Paul. And just 6 months ago, we received this postcard from him. The postmark was Nigeria, and that's why Paul and I are here.
Oh, ridiculous.
What's so funny?
How do you spell Nigeria?
Oh, come now, don't be ridiculous. It's right there on the postmark, Nigeria. And there's a picture of the Nigeria Falls.
Well, that's not spelled Nigeria.
I'm frightened, Paul.
That's spelled Niagara. And that falls Niagara Falls. That's city near Buffalo, New York, right? Yes. But Lena, I have a surprise for you. Lena, have your brother Eugene flown here by Pan African Airline. Two of Lena's brother are now at airport to pick him up.
Eugene, thank heavens you're all right. Paul and I now can go back thanks to Lena, the queen of the jungle.
Wait, Lena do good thing. Not bad to do good thing, but bad to do bad thing. For when Lena do good thing, Lena know she's not good for bad thing. But good thing and bad thing are not what Lena like do. When Lena do good thing, she happy about good thing. For good thing is so different from bad thing. When Lena do bad thing, she unhappy about bad thing. For Lena know that then she do bad thing. And Lena like to do good thing.
We know that you're going to enjoy our next guest. We would also like you to stay tuned for our finale, which is kind of an all-out proposition we've been working at all day. And now, for the versatile gentleman who made the hit recording of Autumn Leaves, here is Roger Williams.
With that record right now. Sebastian, cut it out, will you? And now, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, fella. Now you're really asking for it. Let's hear you play just one more. You could play it, Sebastian. Uh-huh. Yeah. Now, come on, try it again. Once more. No, boy. Okay, the contest is over, Sebastian. I'm awfully sorry, but... Listen, fella, why don't you just take it easy now and let me play a little bit, huh? I tell you, you did pretty good up until then, though. Maybe we could go off with a duet. How about Saber Dance? Do you think you could play that one? At least you were playing it last night. Okay, let's go. Thank you. out. Well, now maybe we'll get around to that record. Now you're tired and you want to go to bed, huh? Say, Bill,
yeah.
Will you come out and put Sebastian to bed
all
so
right,
I can get
Ernie.
On with this next number?
Come on, Sebastian. Time to go home.
Good night, fella, and thanks a lot. Well, you know, now that we're alone, finally, Autumn Leaves has been a little unlucky for Sebastian tonight, but it certainly has been lucky for me. And we just put out a new record that we hope is going to have the same success that Autumn Leaves has. Tumbling Tumbleweeds.
Television has become popular in countries abroad at an accelerated rate. However, the industry, being even newer abroad than it is here, is going through growing pains while the technical end is being smoothed out. Now, here is Edie Adams as a visiting guest star with her whole troupe in an Italian television studio which has not quite yet reached perfection in production standards.
Thank you.
memoria. You can be sure if it's a iceberg.
Next week, we have Boris Karloff, Ema Sumac, and now, how about a good night from the entire cast, huh?